Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Krishna Gopal. In this video, we are going to talk about the part 10 of our the interview questions. We are going to discuss the first question, when to choose the random forest over the support vector machine. The second question, what is our difference between the random forest and the decision tree? And the third question is, list out some hyperparameter which can help us to tune the random forest. So these are the three questions which generally people ask in the service-based companies for the data science interview. So let us start the video. So the first question is, when to choose a random forest over the SVM, that is a support vector machine. Now you see the random forest is actually use the base learner the decision tree. So random forest is actually a bunch of a decision tree, and the decision tree beauty is that decision tree work like the if else condition, that is they not depend on the distance, where the support vector machine is try to maximize the distance between the hyperplane. So it actually based on the distance. Now what the benefit it have, when we have some features whose scale is not same, so in that case the random forest when we use the random forest, we no need to perform the normalization or the mean max scaling to get out of the scale variant problem. We just use the random forest as the data is given us. But in the support vector machine, because it is based on the distance, and to get the good result, we have to perform the normalization, we have to perform the mean max scaling that time to make all the features in the vernis. So this is the one benefit we have when we use a random forest over the SVM. And the second point is that, as I told, random forest is used as the base learner decision tree, and decision tree is actually a if else condition. So the random forest interpretability is more compared to the support vector machine, as it is a distance based machine learning model, where the interpretability of the random forest is much more compared to the support vector machine. Now the third point is that when we have the sparse features, when we have the lot of sparsity, that time the random forest is not up to the mark compared to the SVM. So in that case we can use the SVM. And in other cases also where we find which is the best kernel for that problem, suppose there is a RBF kernel we find it is going to be best suit in this problem, so we apply the SVM, and SVM has worked well compared to the random forest there, if we get the knowledge of the particular kernels. But if we have the blind, if we have no information, then in many more cases the random forest work well if the data is not much more sparse. So this is the these are the cases where the random forest perform well compared to the support vector machine. Now move to the second question, what is the difference between the random forest and the decision tree? Now the already I am speaking this much time, like random forest uses the decision tree as a base learner, but what is the difference? The difference is come when you are going to do the trade-off between the interpretability versus the accuracy. Suppose you want the interpretability, you want your model should be a good interpretable. I want why this feature is behaving like this, I want that interpretability. Then is the beneficial to go for the decision tree, but you not get that much good accuracy. Random forest is interpretable, but not that much interpretable compared to the decision tree. A single decision tree, which what it have? It have the if else condition. We can easily understand why this and why not. But the random forest is what? It mix the many decision tree as a base learner, and the bunch of decision tree we are using. So the interpretability decrease compared to the decision, a single decision tree. But the accuracy increase when we use the random forest. That much accuracy we not get from the decision tree. So this is the one most important. So when it comes to your trade-off between the interpretability versus accuracy, the difference between the random forest and decision tree is increased, and in many cases the random, we want a good accurate model, and the random forest boosts the model score compared to the decision tree. So this is the answer of the second question. This is very important and very general question. We are using the random forest, we are using the decision tree in that, and somebody come and ask what is the difference. We should know the difference, which one when to use. Now the third question is that, which is our important question, list some hyperparameters which is used to tune the random forest model. So as we discussed, the random forest is what doing? It have the base learner, what? It have the lot of the decision tree as the base learner. So as the base learner increase, the variance is decrease, and we are avoiding the overfitting. So this is the one of the most important hyperparameter regarding the random forest. Now, the as we know, the random forest is only used the decision tree. So, what are the hyperparameter which help us to tune the decision tree work well for the random forest as well, like the maximum depth, minimum number of samples in the leaf node. So what are the hyperparameter for the decision tree is going to work for the random forest. So somebody asks, what is a particular? We tell it is a number of base learner. We want higher number of base learner. So I hope you like this video, and if you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe the channel. That's and we will meet soon in the next video. Up to that, take care. Bye bye. Thank you to watch the video.